guys, and welcome to my YouTube video. So today I'm going to be talking about the most influential person of all time, someone who has made so much contribution to the world of management. So I hope you guys are so excited to learn more about this management guru together with me. I introduce you to Renee Mauborgne, one of the most influential women in the world of business management. Her contribution to business management has completely disrupted the conventional wisdom of conducting businesses. Here is a glimpse of her accolades and achievements that I must say are an inspiration to me and others in the business field. So, Renee Mauborgne, who is the INSEAD Distinguished Fellow and a Professor of Strategy at INSEAD, has revolutionized the management sector through her iconic Blue Ocean Strategy, which is a model for businesses to discover uncontested markets that are ripe for growth.
Called Markets Creating Strategic Moves, the Blue Ocean, because the opportunities for all of us out there were unlimited. And there were sets of companies, despite what was happening in the industry, were carving out and creating this new space.
With over 4 million copies of the bestseller Blue Ocean Strategy book sold, Renee continues to contribute innovative and transformative models to help businesses thrive in this ever-volatile and competitive marketplace. These numerous materials have shaped the organizational strategies of many companies and have been the major driving force behind their unparalleled success. To mention a few, Marvel, Health Media, and Stitch Fix have and continue to strategically develop new markets to capitalize on based on the Blue Ocean Strategy. Let's take a quick look at the world's most renowned motion pictures, Marvel. Now, unless you have been living under a rock for the last 50 years, you would have certainly heard of Marvel, or at least you'll be familiar with its notorious characters such as Spider-Man, Wonder Woman, and many more. But what you may not know is that Marvel is one of the greatest examples of red ocean to blue ocean transformation in modern business history. Consider some of the most successful movies of the last decade: The Avengers, Age of Ultron, Infinity War, Endgame, and my all-time favorite, Black Panther. They are the 5 highest grossing superhero films of all time, accounting for half of the lifetime top 10 grossing films of any genre, and all of them were produced by Marvel. But things were not always so bright for Marvel. Just over 2 decades ago, the firm emerged from bankruptcy with $250 million of high interest debt. In 1999, this changed when Peter Cornio, a world-renowned turnaround expert, was appointed as CEO of Marvel.
Peter, talk about what it was like when you took over as CEO of Marvel.
We had 2 problems. The first was financial. We actually, at that time, had $250 million in debt. And the interest rate on that was 12%, so we had to generate at least $30 million in cash to cover the interest, which we couldn't do emerging from bankruptcy. The second problem that we had was that a lot of our business partners, a lot of them had lost money during the Marvel's bankruptcy process. And you had to convince them, and it was not easy to become your partners again after they'd lost money with you.
Using the Blue Ocean strategic approach as a springboard for success, he entered the company into the motion pictures industry, and this has made all the difference. Marvel, which was bankrupt, rode back to success, got acquired by Disney for over $4 billion in just over a decade. And to date, it continues to grow as Marvel Studios. So, how did Marvel do this? Let's take a closer look at the Blue Ocean Strategy and the Red Ocean Strategy, first coined by Renee and Chan Kim to denote the market universe. Red Oceans describe the current marketplace that is so rife with cutthroat competition. Here, businesses compete to own the largest piece of the market by all means possible. This cutthroat competition turns the ocean bloody red. This is why they use the term red ocean. Now, looking at its counterpart, which is the Blue Ocean Strategy. Blue oceans denote or mean all the industries not in existence today, the unknown marketplace, unexplored and untainted by competition. Like the Blue Ocean, this strategy is vast, deep and powerful in terms of opportunity as well as profitable growth. So the norm for executives when it comes to developing a corporate strategy for business and almost always begins with the following. So first, firms will analyze the industry or the environmental conditions in which the company operates. Secondly, they will analyze the strengths and weaknesses of their competitors, and they do this by executing a competition analysis. After this, they use this analysis they have developed in order to actually develop a clear strategy on how to outperform their competitors by creating or even building a distinctive competitive advantage. And to obtain such advantage, a company generally chooses either to differentiate itself from the competition or for a premium price or to pursue low cost. So this is what we can actually see in the Red Ocean. At Marvel, this was evident by its Captain America character, who acted as the hero of World War II. As such, differentiating Marvel in a saturated comic book industry where a lot of competition, which was very rife with competition. Here, Marvel was letting its environment, which was World War II, to define its strategy to use Captain America. And as a result, the company was at the brink of bankruptcy once World War II ended, and sales began to decrease as the character lost its meaning. So, to remain competitive and increase its sales, Marvel developed more superhero characters to attract a new customer segment of teenagers, unlike its former war symbol, Captain America. So these new characters were human first and superhero second. So we have Spider-Man, the Hulk, Iron Man, the X-Men, and so many more characters. And the business thrived because of this. This shift can actually be coined as a Blue Ocean Strategy. So here, what Marvel did was that instead of letting its environment define its strategy, it actually crafted a strategy that defined its environment. All in all, the Blue Ocean Strategy proposes that a company's performance is not necessarily because the industry is very competitive. The Blue Ocean Strategy is about pursuing differentiation and low cost at the same time. As such, it breaks from the value cost trade-off evident in the Red Ocean Strategy and creates a new marketplace. The Blue Ocean Strategy framework can help companies systematically reconstruct their industries and reverse the structure strategy sequence in their favor. In other words, strategy can actually shape structure. Now, looking at the Blue Ocean Framework. The Blue Ocean Framework proposes that for any strategy to succeed and be sustainable, three propositions are needed. These are value proposition, profit proposition, and people proposition. And these propositions need to be aligned. This means that an organization must develop an offering that attracts buyers, creates a model that enables it to make money out of the offering, and it must inspire and encourage its stakeholders to execute the strategy. So firstly, the top executives develop a fully aligned strategy proposition. Secondly, they effectively communicate them to the managers in functional areas with clear responsibilities as well as expectations. Thirdly, they set the strategic objectives in each functional area in line with the aligned strategy proposition. This will actually enable and ensure an overall high-performing and sustainable strategy. So pretty much, business should break off from their value cost trade-off, which is the conventional belief that companies can either create greater value to customers at a higher cost or create reasonable value at a lower cost by aligning the three propositions. So, How did Marvel go about shifting from a red ocean to a blue ocean strategy? So they adopted the ERCC approach, which stands for eliminate, raise, reduce, as well as create. So creating the blue ocean approach. So some of the factors that Marvel within its industry long competed for were Hollywood style operations, big offices, as well as high salaries. So they decided to get rid of this. And then the factors that they decided to actually raise well above the industry standard was a creative culture. They decided to create a creative culture within the organization between the employees as well as their customers. And they also decided to go for storytelling and forming and creating an emotional connection of Marvel Studios with their audience as well. And then for reducing, so what they actually did was that for reducing, they decided to identify these factors. So these factors, they identified them and they were able to raise this well below the industry standard. So these factors were middle management, full price movie stars, company owned physical infrastructure. And lastly, Marvel created a creative committee and a unique financing scheme, as well as created their own universe, which is the Marvel Studios as we know today. And this is very famous and renowned in the studio industry. And all of the strategies or approach that they adopted actually helped Marvel to create new value and remain competitive to date. By executing the strategies or the strategic action, Marvel was able to create unprecedented value at a low cost. And by entering the motion picture industry and value innovating the motion picture production model, Marvel was able to restore its blue ocean to become the most profitable movie franchise in history. From this, we can see that for a successful blue ocean shift, three components are needed. Okay, so let's look into these three components. So the first component is actually a blue ocean perspective. The second component is marketing, creating tools with guidance. And the third one is humanness in the process. I'm going to touch a little bit on this and then I will explain it in detail later. So a blue ocean perspective. So first, the firm needs to adopt a blue ocean perspective in order to expand people's horizons and guide them in the right direction. And secondly, they need market creating tools with guidance on how to actually apply them, build people's creative competence, and open up a new value cost frontier. And then last but not least, we have humanness in the process. So within the whole process of shifting from a red ocean strategy to a blue ocean strategies, they need, or the firm needs, to inspire and build people's confidence so that they own and drive the process for effective execution of the blue ocean shift. So now I think you have gotten a grasp of why companies need to move and must move from the red ocean strategy to the blue ocean strategy. And this is all thanks to Renee Mauborgne. If you're still not yet convinced, here are a few more reasons why they should do so. Finally, some great news for you. If you want to shift your business, your firm, or your organization from a red ocean to a blue ocean, there are a few components that you need to adopt. Number one, you need to develop a blue ocean perspective, and to do this, you need to become a blue ocean strategist. Don't worry, the steps on becoming a blue ocean strategist are outlined here for you. So there are four traits of a blue ocean strategist. First, blue ocean strategists do not take industry conditions as given. Rather, they set out to shape them in their favor. Secondly, number two, blue ocean strategists do not seek to beat the competition. Instead, what they do is that they aim to make the competition irrelevant, as we can see in the case of Marvel. And number three, blue ocean strategists focus on creating and capturing new demand, not fighting over existing customers or competitors. And lastly, blue ocean strategists simultaneously pursue both differentiation as well as low cost. They aim to break, not to make, the value cost trade-off. And then number two, you or your organization needs to implement these five easy steps to make that blue ocean shift. So first, the first step is that you need to get started. You cannot do anything without getting started. So by getting started, you choose the right place to start your blue ocean initiative. Step two, you need to understand where you are now. You need to get clear on the current state of play so you can know where you want to go. Step three, you need to imagine where you could be. You have to uncover the hidden pain points imposed by your industry. What is it that your industry is doing right now that they need to change? Step four, find out how to get there. You need to reconstruct the market boundaries systematically. Step five, make your move. Here you need to select and rapidly test your blue ocean move. And then afterwards, you need to formalize your big picture business model and launch your move. Last but not least, the process of shifting to a blue ocean strategy should be humane. The humanist approach builds the confidence of all the employees to own as well as drive the process for an effective execution of the blue ocean strategy. So, the humanist in the process, or the humanist approach of the blue ocean strategy, has been categorized in three different factors or sectors. First, you have atomization, then you have first hand discovery, and then a fair process. So atomization, what it does is that it breaks the challenge down into small concrete actions. People have the confidence to act on them step by step by step. So this can be done by the person who is in charge of the department. So for example, it can be the CEO. And then the first-hand discovery allows people to see things that they never saw before and realize the need for change. And lastly, a fair process. A fair process actually recognizes people for their intellectual and emotional worth, building trust and inspiring voluntary cooperation. So, what are you waiting for? The answer to making your business thrive again is right here. And here are two phenomenal books that you can read to leave your competition behind. Renee, together with her co-worker Dr. Chan Kim, have made and continue to make a major contribution to the business management world through their revolutionary concept of the Blue Ocean Strategy. They have revitalized companies in highly competitive environments as well by developing new markets. So from this, we can actually see the urgent need for companies, especially those in highly concentrated competitive markets. And that is a wrap off. Thank you for watching. I hope that you guys learned so much about the Blue Ocean Strategy from Renee Mauborgne.